Beekeepers often use the phrase splitting a colony. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to do that. But before I do, let me talk a little bit about what splits are in the first place. Well, in beekeeping, you can fully appreciate a lot of the jargon we use is incredibly descriptive. It explains exactly what we're doing. So splitting a colony is just that. It's taking one colony and making two. So here we have a full-size production colony that's gotten very strong, and I want to split it into this nuc and have two colonies from this one. So what might cause me to split colonies? Well, I've already alluded to one of those reasons. If this colony is very strong, I might want to split it so that I have a second colony. That's a great way of making increases. I can increase my own beekeeping operation. I can get more colonies simply by splitting my stronger colonies. Another reason I might want to split this production colony is this production colony could be heading into the nectar flow, and it might be swarm season. And so I may be a few weeks, maybe 3 or 4 weeks ahead of that nectar flow. The colony is very strong. I don't want it to swarm, because if it splits in two, then I'm not going to maximize the amount of honey that I can produce with this colony. So as one swarm management technique, I might split it as a preemptive strike on this colony's swarm tendency. Another important consideration when thinking about when to split is all about timing. You know, if you split colonies leading up to the nectar flow, then you'll have a lot of resources available in the environment to grow this split. But if you split your colonies after the major nectar flow, you might have to feed that split or the full-size colony to recover those resources that you'll be moving between the two hives. Obviously, making a split in late fall or winter is never advisable unless you live in a tropical or subtropical area, simply because you're creating that second colony at a time of year that it's going to be very difficult to get it up and ready to go through winter. Also, with regard to splits, there's no exact science. I'm just going to show you one way to do it today, but there's really many ways. Let me give you an example of what I mean. This colony is strong, it has a queen. This hive has nothing. There's no bees, nothing. So I'm going to be moving frames of bees over. Do I leave the queen in the production colony? Do I put the queen into the split? Do I make a weak split? In other words, I only give them two frames of brood and maybe a lot of bees, but not much resources. So a weak split that I have to nurture and grow. Or do I make a strong split where five frames of bees and brood come over? So all of those things are kind of personal preference and what it is you're trying to accomplish with your split. Today, I'm going to do kind of a moderate split where I take a frame of honey and pollen from this hive and move it over to create this new hive. And then I'm going to take two frames of brood and put it into this nuc. So it's going to have three frames, one of honey and pollen, two of brood of some sort of stages. I will leave in that split two other frames. In this particular case, I might leave frames of foundation or pulled comb. Here today, I'm going to use two frames of foundation. So I'm making that split a little weak, weaker than I could, and I'm going to put resources into this split to feed them and grow them from there. If I do that, I might can make multiple splits from this colony. As with anything in management, there are really no hard and fast rules, but I'll give you a few what I call Jamie pointers, or a bit my management opinion when I'm deciding whether or not to make a strong split or a weak split. I might be more likely to make a weaker split if I had a purchased queen that I'm going to put into here, or if I was moving the old queen from the parent hive into the split, because they would have queens ready to go, ready to crank out brood. I might make stronger splits if I was going to sell the split nearly instantly to another beekeeper, or if I wasn't giving this split a queen at all and I was allowing them to requeen themselves. If you think about the requeen process, it can take about 2 weeks to make a queen, 2 weeks for her to mate, and 3 weeks for her first egg to go through all of its stages of development before they emerge as adult bees. So if I'm going to make a queenless split that I allow to requeen themselves, I want to have a lot of cap brood, a lot of adult bees, so that as they're waiting for that new queen to mate and start laying eggs and that attrition of bees, it's not crashing quickly on me. So again, this is not really a strategy about making strong splits or weak splits or queens or no queens. It's just simply to show you a few techniques associated with it. Here, this is a five-frame nuc. So I've got five frames in this nuc that I'm going to move into this hive. Five frames from the hive I'm going to move into the nuc, or some combination thereof. I've already alluded to the fact that I'm probably going to make a three-frame split from this hive. So what I'll do is I'll take out the middle three frames from this nuc. It happens to be a combination of foundation and drawn comb. I'll sit those aside, and what I'm leaving behind in this nest are two frames of foundation. I'm able to do that for one of two reasons. I happen to be going into a major nectar flow here, but if I wasn't, then I know that I could be providing resources. And so whether the nectar is providing that resource or you are providing that resource, there will be enough incoming resources for the bees I put into this nuc to pull out these two frames of foundation. So what I'm going to do when I create this split is I'm going to go through this hive and I'm going to move over a frame of cap brood, because I want that quick emergence of adult bees to beef up the population. I'm going to move over a frame of honey and pollen so this hive comes preloaded with resources. And then I'm going to move over a frame of eggs and young larvae because I want this colony to make its own queen. But I'm also going to take a couple of frames of just bees from this hive and shake into here. So they're essentially getting five frames of bees, even though they're only getting three frames with bees. That means this colony will have the queen. It will lose some of its bees, some of its brood, a little bit of its resources, but the onus will be here to make a new queen. And I know that I'm going to try to increase my likelihood of success by not leaving this split in this apiary, because if I did, the bees would fly back to their parental nest. I'm going to take this nuc to another apiary where the queen that emerges from the cell someday will be able to take over in this nest. She's going to mate elsewhere, and I'll have very few bees leave this nuc to return to its parent hive. So in other words, I'll minimize my bee loss due to attrition. So as I get ready to work this hive, I've got the resources ready to take care of my nuc. I'll smoke the hive and I'll go straight to the brood box. I'm not even going to bother with the super on this nest. I'm not taking bees from it. Obviously, there's no brood up in it because we have a queen excluder, so I'm just going to go straight to the brood box. Got this queen excluder on the nest. Remember, I want to find the queen in here because I'm going to leave her behind. I don't want to place her into that split that I'm making. So check underneath the queen excluder. I do not see the queen, but in the event that I missed her, I'm just going to lay it up against the face of this hive here. And now I've got the slightly onerous but still necessary task of going through this hive to look for the queen. Now I know that I'm likely to have frames of honey and pollen resources on the outer edge, and my typical pattern of working a hive is starting with the second frame. So I'm going to remove the second frame, see if it's a good candidate for moving into this nuc. And by good candidate, it means either it has a lot of capped brood or it's a frame of mostly eggs or young larvae. Remember, I'm moving over eggs and young larvae because I'm going to want that split to requeen itself. So I look here and see this frame is largely a mixture of capped brood as well as open cells that contain eggs and young larvae. I'm going to check this frame for the queen, but I don't consider this frame the appropriate frame to move over into that nuc. So without seeing the queen on this frame, I'm going to lay the frame up against my hive. And now I'm going to work this frame, which is almost certainly a resource frame. And sure enough, I pull it up. It's full of honey and pollen. So I'm going to move this frame over into that nuc because it's going to be the frame that I use as the resources going into that nuc. But I just want to see for sure if the queen is here. If she's not, then I know I've got to continue looking for her. Now I progress through the nest, looking both for the queen as well as frames of either mostly cap brood or mostly eggs and young larvae. When I'm looking specifically to it, cap brood, obviously brood can be capped for over a week. So really what I'm looking for is capped brood that's older, and I can tell that it's older because what I will see is bees actively emerging from the capped cells. So this frame here is potentially a good candidate for eggs and young larvae because I've got a thin band of capped brood that's actively emerging brood, but not enough to count as my emerging brood. But I've got lots of eggs and young larvae in this frame. So as a result, I'm going to let it serve as my eggs and young larvae frame, and I'm going to move it right into this nook. Now at this point, I've moved over two frames that I wanted there. I want to make sure I have space to shake bees from a couple of other frames in there, so I'm going to remove another frame from that nook, and I'm going to continue looking for the queen or the optimum frame. This is a good frame of cap brood, but before I put it in there, I've got a lot of cap brood on this side and a lot of it's emerging, so I'm going to move it over. But before I put it in there, I just want to confirm that I can find the queen in this nest. So I found the queen on this frame, and I don't want her to end up in the nuke. Remember, I'm making that nuke, that split, queenless. So I'm just going to simply put this frame with the queen on it right over here out of the way, which means now I can move into that nuke the frame that had the brood that I wanted. But before I do that, if you remember earlier in my conversation, I said that I was going to try to beef up this split's population by adding two extra frame of bees, but not the frames themselves. Since I just do that by shaking the frame right into the nest, like so. So again, in this particular case, I'm making kind of a modest size population of bees in this nuke. So they get three frames of brood or resources, two frames of shaken bees. Here's that frame that's principally capped brood. Now I'm going to return that one frame of foundation, and what I've created again, two frames of foundation, a frame of resources, two frames of brood, shaking two extra frames of bees in here, and now I've got my split. And I could take that split off to another apiary, allow that queen to mate. And again, there are so many strategies for splits. Maybe I wanted to move the queen over. Maybe this one's going to requeen itself. Maybe this one's going to requeen itself. Maybe I have two new queens to put in both of them. Regardless, splitting colonies is simple. And as a last piece of advice, all of the frames don't have to come from the same parent hive. Maybe this colony's pretty strong, but not great, and that colony's pretty strong, but not great, but still I want to split. I might take a frame of bees and brood from here and a frame of bees and brood from here, combine them into this single split. Another option is maybe I didn't want this production colony to exist at all after I was done. I just put three of its frames here. With all the bees and brood and resources I have, I can make two more splits from this colony. I could take one colony and make three instead of one colony and making two. So now that I have this split established, I'm going to squeeze these frames back together, those frames that actually originated in this nest, bees, brood, and all. I remember that I have my queen on a frame outside of the nest. I'm going to confirm that she's there before I put it back into the nest. And sure enough, she is, so I'm going to put it back into the nest safely. I'll grab all the frames, push them towards the center, and then remember I took three frames out of here, so I've got to put three frames back. I happen to have two frames of foundation to put on the outer walls of this hive, and I've also got a frame of pulled comb that honestly I could put anywhere in the nest because the bees can use it instantly. The key to splits is just don't overthink it. I get so many questions. Is it better to start with two frames of eggs or three frames of eggs or two frames of cap brood or a queen over here or the queen over here? Honestly, there's so many ways to do it. Really what you're wanting to do is create a critical mass over here that can survive while leaving a critical mass here that can survive. And depending on your timing, you may need to provide a lot of resources for the split to grow or for the production colony to recover, or Mother Nature can provide those resources. What I would do at this point is, knowing I left the queen here, I would follow up with this split 7 days later to make sure they're building queen cells, and then another 7 days later to ensure the queen has emerged, and then I'd give her about 2 weeks to start laying eggs. So in this split scenario, it's gonna be about 4 weeks, plus or minus, before I start seeing eggs. But that's okay, because the reason I created the split was the long-term goal of just having more colonies. Again, if I wanted to sell it instantly, I might put a queen in, etc. Splits are a great way to manage a swarm. Splits are a great way to grow your apiary. Splits are a great way to have additional income. I hope you enjoy making splits in your beekeeping operation.